Power of Truth coming to you from ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA, every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. Join the Minister of God, Pastor I.G. Fakunle, the Apostolic Church Area Superintendent, Ilesha, Osun State, Nigeria. For inquiries, call this number, +234-906-481-1278, +234-906-481-1278. Remember, it is every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. on ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA. Jesus is Lord.
Unto the Lord, our God, be all glory, honor, and praise. A fortnight ago, I spoke to you on youths as agents of revival, and last week, I spoke on the power of thanksgiving. These are messages that are meant to challenge you so that your life will not remain the same again. Today, I'm going to speak on the topic, Lessons of Faith from a Nobleman. Lesson of Faith from a Nobleman. Come with me to John chapter 4, verse 15. John chapter 4, verse 15. Jesus said unto him, Go thy way, thy son liveth. And the man believed the word that Jesus had spoken unto him, and he went his way. What happened here? The Bible described somebody as a nobleman. The Bible did not give us his name, but it is possible that this man was a high-ranking government official who heard of Jesus, and he had a serious problem. What was his problem? His child was seriously sick to the point of death. This man, being a wealthy man, he must have tried every other thing before he came to Jesus. You see? And when he came to Jesus, in that verse 49, the nobleman said unto him, Sir, come down, here my child died. Come down before my child dies. You see? And Jesus Christ spoke to him, Go your way, your son lives. And the Bible said, this man turned and went home. And the child lived. We need to learn certain things about faith from this man. Thank God the Bible did not give us his name, Thank God the Bible did not even tell us whether he was an Israelite or a Gentile. That means what he did, God wants everybody to do it. We can learn from him. You see, when you are dealing with God, because you cannot see God face to face, faith is indispensable in our dealings with God. It is indispensable because we cannot see God face to face. So, we must deal with him by faith. In Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6, "But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him." You see that? Without faith, it is impossible to please God. And in Luke chapter 1 verse 37, the Bible said, "For with God nothing shall be impossible." If there is no impossibility with God, then you must know how inescapable faith is in our relationship to him. However, faith must be developed. It must be promoted to be productive. See, faith must be developed. It must be promoted before it could be productive. That is the problem of some people. They don't develop their faith. And so, they met with disappointment. You see, the aforementioned nobleman in John chapter 4, which I've mentioned to you, gave us some tutorials on faith. You see, telling us that my faith must grow. Your faith must grow. See, every living plant grows. The same thing, your faith must grow. We now want to see what are the steps this man took that nourishes his faith, and for which we too can learn and appropriate so that our faith can grow in the Lord. You see, number one, in that John chapter 4, John chapter 4, I want to read it, verses 46 and 47. John chapter 4, 46 and 47. "So Jesus came again into Cana of Galilee, where he made the water wine. And there was a certain nobleman whose son was sick at Capernaum. When he heard that Jesus was come out of Judea into Galilee, he went unto him and besought him that he would come down and heal his son, for he was at the point of death." That's it. You see, the genesis of the faith of this man was that he had a problem he could not solve. And that is basic. As you are listening to me, or you may know people who have problems, there is a particular need in your life which on your own you cannot solve it. You cannot provide it. And that is the genesis of faith. You believe that God can do what you cannot do. You believe that God can do what others cannot do for you. That is the genesis of faith. Believing that God can do the impossible. This man, you see, when he heard of Jesus, he met Jesus at Cana, where he turned water into wine. So this man believed that if this Jesus can do it, so that those who invited him to their wedding were not put to shame, if I approach him, he will not put me to shame. And that is basic. You need to have that primary conviction in your heart that if I take my problem to Jesus, he will not disappoint me. That is where your faith can germinate. Because if you don't have confidence in God, it means you don't have faith in Him. And if you have confidence in God, it means your faith in Him will flourish. That is number one. Every human being has a grave need which he or she cannot meet, but God can meet it. Whatever you are passing through as you are listening to me now, you have tried everything, but nothing works. Try Jesus. Try faith in God. Try faith in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. That is the beginning. See, number two, in that John chapter 4, verses 48 and 49, then said Jesus unto him, except ye see signs and wonders, ye will not believe. The nobleman said unto him, sir, come down, ere my child died. Look at that. The second step of promoting your faith is persistence. You have to be persistent. That means don't give up. Don't you ever listen to the devil that it is impossible. Persist that with God all things are possible. And whatever you bring to God for solution shall be possible. See, let me show you a good example of Prophet Jeremiah. How he persisted. See, Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 15. Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 15. O Lord, thou knowest, remember me, visit me, and revenge me of my persecutors. Take me not away in thy long suffering. Know that for thy sake I have suffered rebuke. Look at that. Jeremiah persisted before God. Say, God, I don't have any other person who can fight my battle. I don't have anybody who can provide solution to this shame I am passing through. Only you. And did God disappoint him? No. He was not disappointed. Even as you are listening to me now, be persistent in your faith. You don't look at circumstances. Look beyond your circumstances to the God who has solution to every problem, and you will not be disappointed. Number three, in that John chapter 4, verse 50, which I read to you, Jesus said unto him, go thy way, thy son liveth. And the man believed the word that Jesus had spoken unto him, and he went his way. You see, faith must be active. The moment this man had the pronouncement of Jesus, he did not even ask, how are you going to do it? When are you coming? Please don't come late. Please, I'm waiting for you. No, he just turned. He believed that everything has been settled because God has spoken. The same thing. If you believe what God has said will come to pass in your life, take it. And you are going to see what will happen. Your trust in Jesus must be unwavering. You see, you must act upon your faith. It is very, very important. You must act upon your faith. Your trust in Jesus Christ must not be shaken. You see, in 1 Samuel chapter 1, let us see what Hannah did. 1 Samuel chapter 1, verses 17, 17 to 19. Then Eli answered and said, go in peace, and the God of Israel grant thee thy petition that thou hast asked of him. And she said, let thy handmaid find grace in thy sight. So the woman went away and did eat, and her countenance was no more sad. And they rose up in the morning early and worshipped before the Lord, and returned and came to their house at Ramah. And Elkanah knew Hannah his wife, and the Lord remembered her. You see that? Anna acted on her faith that the servant of God prayed for me before the altar of God, so it is a done deal. It's settled. I am no longer barren. I am pregnant. And that's all. When she got home and met her husband, the answer came. The same thing, whatever it is in your life, consider it settled once you hand it over to God. Expect it. You see, faith must be full of expectation. See, do you remember Daniel? See, look at those people. Here was fire. And the king said, if you don't bow down, we will throw you into the fire. They said, no, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the fire. They did not run away. And they were thrown inside the fire. And where was God waiting for them? Inside the fire. He did not allow the fire to burn them. Let me tell you, God is waiting for you at your point of arrival. When you follow God, you are going to discover that his yes is always yes. There is no yes and no with God. No. His yes is always yes. See, then as I've told you, the next thing, stage for your faith, is that faith must be rooted in positive expectation. You see, your faith must be rooted in positive expectation. In that John chapter 4, verses 51 and 52, I read, and as he was now going down, his servants met him and told him, saying, thy son liveth. Then inquired he of them the hour when he began to amend. And they said unto him, yesterday at the seventh hour, that fever left him. And that was the hour that Jesus Christ spoke to him, saying, go, your son is alive. You see, expectation. Your expectation must not be defeated. Once you have placed your faith in God, expect miracles. Expect God to move, and he will never deny you. It is very, very important. Jesus Christ said, if you have faith as small as the seed of mustard, and you believe without doubting in your heart, if you speak to this mountain, move, it will move. The same thing. Pray with expectation. See, your faith must be planted solidly in your trust in God, that God will not disappoint me. God is never a God of disappointment. It is very, very important. Then, faith must be declared before others. You see, in that John chapter 4, verses 52 to 54, then inquired he of them the hour when he began to amend. And they said unto him, yesterday, at the seventh hour, the fever left him. So the father knew that it was at the same hour in the which Jesus said unto him, thy son liveth, and himself believed, and his whole house. This is again the second miracle that Jesus did when he was come out of Judea into Galilee. Do you see that? See, you must be ready to give witness. There are many people today, oh, they say that I must have the proof before I give witness. No. Your testimony, the testimony of your faith, the testimony of your confidence in God, the testimony that what God has started in your life, he will complete it. Come with me to the book of Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. Philippians chapter 1 verse 6. He said, being confident of this very thing, that he which had begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Do you see that? Your confidence in Christ, that is what will make your faith productive. Come with me again to the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 35. Cast not away therefore your confidence, which hath great recompense of reward. You see, when you plant your faith in God, that faith will not die. You see, testify, give testimony. You see, when you do that, that's what the Bible means by saying that do not cast away your confidence in God. You see, what you are saying may not be what you are expecting. You take your eyes off from anything negative. Fix it on what is positive in Christ. And you are going to see miracles happening in your life. So this man had his sorrow turned to joy. Why? Because he learned and mastered the lessons of faith. That's why in Mark chapter 11, Mark chapter 11, I want to read verses 22 to 24. What does it say? Mark 11, 22 to 24. And Jesus answering said unto them, have faith in God. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he said. Therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire, when ye pray, believe that ye receive them, and ye shall have them. Father, I pray, whatever may be the problem anybody is carrying, whatever may be the problem anybody is facing, those who have decided to exercise their faith in you today, give them that type of faith that will overcome problems so that their joys will be full. Father, I pray for those who are weak in the faith. Father, increase their faith in the mighty name of Jesus so that as from today, they will have testimonies that the Lord has done them good. In Jesus' name I've prayed. Amen. The Lord bless you and solve all your problems and give you testimonies. In Jesus' name, amen. See you next week.
In the midst of the darkness shining, Jesus, light of the world, shine upon us.
This is the power of truth coming to you from ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA, every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. Join the Minister of God, Pastor I.G. Fakunle, the Apostolic Church Area Superintendent, Ilesha, Osun State, Nigeria. For inquiries, call this number, +234-906-481-1278, +234-906-481-1278. Remember, it is every Sunday at 6 to 6:30 p.m. on ABN TV channels, Houston, Texas, USA. Jesus is Lord.